So this is part two of cooking in Hastings, my hometown. And as you can see, believe it or not, the sun is still shining. These beautiful boats you see in these images are known as clinkerbilt boats, and they were first registered in Hastings in 1958 and are still in full use today, sometimes going out to sea for up to 12 hours at a time. These are the boats that bring us the beautiful fish that we'll be using in today's segment. And today, we're going to be using one of my most favorite fishes, plaice. So this is the fish we chose. We chose plaice, which is very common here in Hastings. Also Dover sole, a lot of flat fishes are very common. The reason I chose the plaice is because of its size. If you come and have a look at the fish itself, it's very plump. This is obviously a flat fish, and all flat fish start out as a round fish with their eyes on either side, and then eventually their eyes flatten out so their bodies can lay flat on the ocean bed. And obviously the underside of this fish is white, so the predators cannot see the fish because it's almost the same color as the sand, and it's camouflaged by what these are called as sunspots. So to tell freshness of a fish, there's a couple of key things. First of all is the eyes need to be bulgy and clear. See how they're bulging and they move around. If they're dried and sunken, then there's a good sign that the fish isn't fresh. Another sign is the gills. Unfortunately, they've cut the gills out of this one, but what you're looking for is a nice blood red, a deep blood red, and of course, wetness. And then the third thing you're looking for, which sounds kind of strange, which might not be able to tell from a fish which is cut up, is actually what's known as sea slime. This is sea slime here. If it's nice and slimy, which sounds funny, it's nice and slimy, then obviously the fish is fresh as well. And then the last thing to tell from a whole fish is how firm it is. If you press your finger and it bounces back, it's a good fresh fish. If you press it in and it doesn't respond, then it's dried out and it's starting to get old. So for this type of fish, we're gonna need two types of knives. This is a boning knife, which is hard, and a fillet knife, which looks almost the same, but it's very bendy. Both, of course, have to be really sharp. So let's go over how to fillet the plaice. So there's a natural line on plaice, and most flatfish have this natural line, which is a good indicator of where to put your knife. On the other side of the gill, we're going to cut down the side of the head using our boning knife, and then cut a straight line down that natural line all the way through to the plaice. Then we're going to switch knives and use our sharp fillet knife, and then using the length of the knife and just making one long stroke, we'll be able to take the fillet straight off of the plaice, and you see here, leaving no flesh on the bone structure itself, okay? And then we're gonna skin this in a second. I'll show you how to do that in 1 minute, but we're gonna get four sides out of this plaice. There's two on the top, which are gonna be the thicker pieces, and then on the bottom, they're gonna be the same, but a little bit thinner. So once you've got all four sides cut off, these are obviously our top sides, you want to skin these. You don't have to, you can skin them after you cook them, but I like to keep them skinned so we can roll them. So we're going to make a little incision here, a little C cut I call it, so it gives you a little kind of a handle. Now you take our sharp fillet knife, start cutting like this, and then once we get a good amount in, about 2 or 3 inches, you're actually going to wiggle the tail and not the knife, and you'll get all the flesh off the skin, leaving a nice piece of plaice. So you're just going to repeat this on all four pieces of fish, and like I said before, have sharp knives. It really is the key to good butchery. If you are nervous about filleting fish yourself, your fishmonger will be able to do it for you. And all I'm going to do with these fillets is just roll them in three like this and place them in a baking dish.
Ooh, what's that I smell? I smell fish. I smell plaice. Plaice is my favorite.
So let's go over the ingredients for the main dish. First things first, you want streaky bacon, and you need that to be smoked, not just cured, and make sure it's smoked. So you want a salty, smoky flavor. These, we are lucky enough here to have these brand new Jersey Royals, which are a new potato crop. If you wanted, you could use fingerling potatoes or any baby potato, but of course, while the Jerseys are in season, we're going to use them. Creme fraiche, if you can't find creme fraiche, you can always use a double cream or even a heavy whipping cream. Onions, garlic, we're going to use leeks, a little bit of dry white wine again, butter. Now don't use margarine, don't use a substitute for butter, this isn't an olive oil dish, we're using a English unsalted butter. You want a butter with no added water, otherwise it will ruin the dish. And then the last piece is a fantastic element, which is English peas. And you don't want to use frozen peas or canned peas. If they're not in season, then you can use frozen peas, but of course the fresh is best. So we're going to pop all these out of our pods. And once that's ready, we'll go into the production of the dish. You can't beat good English peas and you can't beat bacon, so this dish should be fantastic. So for your bacon, you're just going to cut this into large pieces called lardons, or just rough chunks is fine. Garlic, you're going to need about 3 or 4 cloves, finely sliced. And of course, onion. Onion, you want a large dice and about 1 or 2 onions, depending on your taste. For the leeks, make sure you wash and clean them first and then slice them on a diagonal in large pieces. So you add the bacon to a hot saucepan and then we're just going to cook it out or render it out to get the fat out of it. And we're going to use that fat to brush over our plaice and it'll keep it nice and moist in the oven, but it'll also help pair with the sauce because the sauce is going to have a pronounced bacon or smoke flavour, and by brushing the plaice with the bacon fat, then we also aid in pairing the fish with the sauce. Okay, so the fat is rendered out of the bacon. Beautiful. So we're just going to take that. We're just going to brush that on top of our plaice quite liberally. We don't want the plaice to dry out in any spots. And you won't need to do too much seasoning because, of course, the bacon is cured, which means it's got a salty flavor. Into the bacon, you're going to add your onions, your garlic, and your leek. And you're going to stir it in well and cook it out for about 4 or 5 minutes. So now your leeks are cooked out, you don't want to lose too much color on them, so keep them nice and colorful, but keep them soft too. I'm going to add about 1/2 bottle of wine. About, look at that, perfect. And we're going to bring that to a boil, so turn the heat up and we're going to let it simmer until a lot of that liquid is reduced. So new potatoes don't need much. I would recommend a touch of salt and cold water to boil. Don't put them in hot water. You don't need to peel them. The skins are very thin, so you can eat them with skins on. We're just gonna cook them until they're soft and then just crush them a little bit. So it's kind of like a skin on mash. So cold water, bring to a boil, simmer till tender. That's it, a little bit of butter maybe. So this is almost the last stage, and at this stage you're going to do a few different things. First of all, you're going to add your peas to your sauce mixture, which is simmered down and reduced by about 1/2. I'm going to stir those in, still keeping them on a fairly high boil, okay? The next thing you want to do is strain your potatoes, which we just did here, and they are ready to mash. You can see they're nice and soft, but not too soft. They've still got some firmness to them. And then of course, you want to get your fish in. So by the time your fish is cooked, the sauce will be ready. We're going to mash our potatoes with a little bit of butter, and that's all you need to do, and everything will be ready at exactly the same time. This is the last stage of the sauce other than seasoning. We're going to add our creme fraiche. We're going to add about 3 large spoonfuls, which is about 200 milliliters of creme fraiche. And of course, if you're using a whipping cream or a heavy whipping cream, double cream, whatever, you can adjust your amounts according to the thickness of that cream. And then the last thing I want to add, which wasn't discussed before, is tarragon. I chose to use tarragon because there is a classic pairing with fish, with peas and tarragon, and it's absolutely fantastic with this bacon sauce. So we're going to add a touch of tarragon to this, about 2 large tablespoons. Check the seasoning, salt and pepper, a squeeze of lemon if you need to. Other than that, the sauce is completely done. All we're doing now is waiting for the fish. We loosely mashed our new potatoes with some nice butter, salt and pepper. And of course, our butter was unsalted, so check the seasoning on that too. And you are almost done. In goes the tarragon. Stir it in. Gives it a nice little fresh herb flavor. Tarragon's got kind of a licorice flavor or an aniseed flavor. And doesn't that look beautiful? So that goes on top of your fish, or you can serve it on the side. I prefer to serve mine on the plate first, and then with our mash and our fish right on the very top, a little squeeze of lemon, and it's absolutely perfect.
is a big-eyed fish swimming in the sea. Oh, how it dreams to be a bird swooping, diving through the breeze. So one day, caught a big old wave up onto the beach. Now is dead, you see. Beneath the sea is where I feel.